Saturday night at Hog Wild, the Booty Man thought he was going to be part of the New World Order, but that all drastically changed. Here's Up Close with the Booty Man.
The hoaxster was always somebody, was always there for me. He was always somebody that was a constant in my life. I remember the time when he talked me into cutting my hand on the playground, and we put our hands together and became blood brothers for life. Back in into the 80s, and I had a pretty good wrestling career going, and my mother was in a bout with cancer. I had got the call that mother was real sick. My mother was sick. When I came back, she was laying in a bed, just basically comatose. As soon as I got off that plane, I rushed there and to be there. And the last words that she said was, my Eddie, my son. And she lapsed into a coma and died that night. And it was a tragedy. It was difficult times for me and my life. But the hoaxster was there for me. After about a year passed, one day I got a call in Philadelphia. Dad had had a heart attack and had passed away. And that was just the beginning. The hoaxster was always there for me. He was always something that I could reach out for. He was a constant in my life. Now it's my job now to try to hold the family together, brothers and sisters that were left. And, you know, I took on the job. And one day I came home, short time later, and the door was locked in my house, and my key didn't work, and my family left. Well, my business was closed. My wife had run off with one of the guys that worked in my restaurant. I was feeling pretty, pretty well defeated right here. I went back to a 4th of July party at a friend's house, and that's when, bam. The accident happened that nearly took my life. I was hit in the face by a girl's knees in a parasailing accident, kind of a freak accident. I just couldn't believe it. Why me? Why did these things keep happening to me? When I came to in the hospital, I felt the clamp of the Hulkster's hand in mine, and I heard him saying, "Don't give up, brother. We love you, man." Even that's gone. But now, I've come to find out that it was just business.
Ring, this is part two of a very special up close and personal interview with a man attacked brutally by the NWO recently at Hog Wild, a former close friend of Hulk Hogan. Here's Up Close Part Two with the Booty Man on Saturday night.
The things that I did for Hulk, I didn't want anything back from. I didn't expect anything. I did those things because he was my friend. I was proud of Hulkster. I was proud to be his friend. I was proud of his accomplishments. And I lived in those accomplishments too. Just can't believe that it's over like this. The horseman had jumped me in the ring because I was a friend of Hulk's. WCW had kind of made a stand and basically gave me the message that they didn't really have any use for me. The next day I got up and the mail came and there was an invitation to Hulk's birthday party. I still felt like I had something there. I had something to fall back on as a voice had Hulk, seems like, as far back as I can remember, as my friend. And I got a birthday cake. And I went out to the ring there, and I didn't agree with the NWO, but that didn't really matter. And when the Hulk reached out and said I was family and kissed me on the cheek and stood back and said, "This ain't personal, this is just business." When those guys were holding me and he took that heavyweight championship belt and whacked me across the face. It just pulled my heart out. This is the friendship that I thought would never end wasn't maybe never even really a friendship at all. And I was just laying there by myself with the people spitting on me and people throwing stuff at me. I got the message loud and clear. I just can't believe the Hulkster used me like he did and made me believe during all these years that our friendship really meant something. I've come to find out that I was just business. I just don't know which way to go. I don't even know who I really am anymore. I'm not the booty man. I'm not the Zodiac. I'm not the butcher. I don't have a place. I don't fit in. I don't know where I belong anymore. I don't think it's gonna be wrestling anytime soon. Just think I need some time.